Hi, welcome back to Cheyenne, Wyoming Urban Gardener. And what you're looking at out here is we are getting started on cleaning up out here. Doesn't kind of look like it right now, but we got started. We kind of got a late start today on cleaning up the garden outside. And I'm starting with trying to work up a little bit more space over here in the, this is like the north side, but actually like northeast. And this is where we have the bird feeders and some of our flowers and stuff like that. And our pumpkins grow really, really well right here in this section. So I'm getting ready to actually run the tiller through this, but I'm going to break it up first and see if we can actually get this pretty wide all through here and then all the way back into this section and all the way around. Now I've got a couple of rhubarbs here in this section. I've also got some hanging pots here. And I put my sunflowers out here and they did really well last season. So I've got a couple of rhubarb out here that I have to really watch because I don't want to move them. They're doing really, really well here. They've already gotten some leaves on them. But I want to extend this on out all the way out through here following the curb. You can just tell our wind has been terrible here in Wyoming the past couple of weeks. We've had 60 to 65 mile per hour winds. Multiple days in a row, so we've had things just blowing apart. I'm now missing my garden flag. I have no idea where it went to. It flew away. But we're going to go ahead and extend this on out, get this tilled all the way around this tree. And you can see that is our septic, sewer, really. I'm not sure what they call those, outspouts or what, but they go down in and clean the drains through there. But we're going to go ahead and get this tilled all the way around through here and put pumpkins and probably butternut squash and things like that. Maybe the Tahitian squash out here because we don't really grow anything in this section. It's just mostly the bird feeders and just some of my flowers. So we're going to grow some more food out in this section. I don't think I'm going to do the north side this season because it's too much. Taking off more than I can chew. But we are getting started on cleaning up. Right there is the carrot bed. We've started cleaning that up and getting that kind of broken up. I'm going to move some things around this season, kind of rotate some crops. Probably going to take out these onions through here, the ones that look like they've got some dried up parts on them. They're just now coming back out, but I'm probably just going to go ahead and get these removed and get some new onions planted in here. I'm just going to put onions all along the back. That is bunching onions, not the bulbing onions. So I'll put that all along the back, and we've got our chive patch right here. And I'll just have those onions all the way in the back. And they've always done really well if you do the bunching onions. And then through here, I'm going to put lettuce because it's just like the perfect size to just have a lettuce bed through here of all kinds of different lettuces. And it did really, really well last season. I had some of the most wonderful lettuce just right through here. I've started working on the new trellises. I had gotten two panels and thought that would be enough, but nope, we actually need probably two more panels, as you can see right here. But started going ahead and digging the trenches for peas. I'm going to plant peas through here, probably two rows on each side, and then just keep planting and keep them growing the whole time. But basically what happened was we were going to till today because it was up near 70 degrees, but unfortunately my brand new tiller that I had bought last season just chose not to work this time. We could not get it started. We're not sure what's wrong with it, so we're gonna have to call somebody to come out and look at it or haul it over to them and have them fix it. But this is a Craftsman. I didn't really show anybody the tiller last season, but it is a Craftsman tiller. We bought it last season. It was over $900. I think over $1,000 with tax. And it's a 208cc Craftsman counter rotating tines. And it is a rear tine tiller, as you can see. So pretty cheap for a rear tine tiller, to be honest, because I remember my mother spending more than $2,000 on hers. And I think she got one of those, oh, I forget what it's called. It's not a Mantis or anything, but it was like one of those specialized ones. It was over $2,000, and this one was over $1,000 with tax. And this season, It just will not start. We're not sure what's going on. It, as you can see, it still looks brand new. We had really maintained it before it went into the garage to be stored. And we're just not sure what's going on with it. So we'll have to get that repaired. And then our lawnmower also, we're going to have to get repaired. Which our lawnmower we bought 5 years ago. So it's about time for it to be serviced. It just would not start. Probably a spark plug or something. But my partner's not too keen on fixing those kinds of things. So he will be taking those to get those fixed. Probably will not cost very much, I'm sure. Because it's probably really something simple. But anyway, we're just getting started on cleaning everything up in the garden for the new gardening season. Still planning on doing something different with this section over here along the fence. We do have a hardy kiwi that is for more cooler climate. So we may run that along the fence. I think I've pretty much decided on that, just to have the kiwi run along the fence, because it gets pretty big and we've got two of them. And we've started cleaning out this other garden bed as well. So this one's probably 25 by 35 maybe. It's pretty big. This is where we put our potatoes and our corn. And I do have some shallots that are in here that are already up. You can kind of see those. It's kind of getting dark, so it's kind of hard to see. But hopefully you can see those. We got some shallots and some garlic in there. But we're starting to get this all cleaned up, breaking up the soil. There's a big stump in here right here. You can see pieces of the wood there. And what we do with this is we just put a large pot sitting right up on top of it, so that way it kind of marks where the stump is. And then we can still have growing space. But this season I think I'm going to actually plant the corn the other direction rather than how I have, so it just gets more sun. So I think I'm going to plant the corn this way. And I think I'll plant the potatoes over here, because it's a little bit more shaded, and potatoes do fine in shade. Not horribly shaded, but just a little bit more shaded. So we'll put the potatoes in here, I believe. We've got a stump right here we cannot get out as yet. Usually I just wait for those to kind of break down, and then I can get them dug out. I had one a couple of seasons ago over there, and we got that one out. So just kind of waiting, see if we can get that one out a little bit easier. And then, of course, we've started working on all the containers. I showed you those in a video yesterday. But we do have a new kiddie pool that is a new strawberry bed. We've got two now. This one has 17 plants in it, strawberry plants. And the other one, I think, has probably 20 or so, because it had runners last season and they just kind of took hold everywhere. So got that going on. My grandson's solar light just cut on. You can see that there, and it has a little dragonfly on it, and it was worked all last season, and it's working this season just perfectly. So we've got that going on. So definitely getting everything up and going over here for the gardening season. You can see we've been working on the pots. We got some potting soil over there that we're just topping off, and lots more to do. So we can get some rutabagas out here going and just keep working on stuff. So like, subscribe, hit the notification bell to see notices on new videos as they come out. And we shall see you in the next one.